If you want to stay updated about our channel, then please subscribe and hit that bell. Please enjoy the video. Start the skin dive by having your mask on and your snorkel in your mouth. Take a couple of really nice deep breaths, and once you're ready, take a final deep breath and swim slowly down towards the bottom. Swim under the water for a few meters, and then when you reach the surface, clear your snorkel using the blast method. Keep your mask and snorkel in your mouth. For the dive equipment setup, start by inspecting the scuba tank and check all the numbers on the tank. Especially check the hydrostatic test date and check your visual inspection, making sure that all the dates are correct. Check if the O-ring is in there and that it is in great condition. Then check the tank valve which way is open and closed, and give it a little burst to clean the valve. Once that's okay, grab your BCD at the BCD handle, put your safety strap away, and then correctly place the BCD over your scuba tank. Make sure that it's at least 4 fingers from the top, and then close the buckle. Double check if everything is attached. Make sure that the tank valve is parallel with the BCD handle. Place on the safety strap and tighten the safety strap accordingly. Again, double check your BCD handle that it's parallel to your tank valve. You can also check if the tank is not too high or too low by placing your hand and fingers at the top of your valve and your BCD. Now, to make sure that everything is attached correctly, grab your BCD tank or the handle of your BCD and then give it a little wiggle. Just make sure you be careful of your back. Grab your regulator, unscrew the dust cap from the first stage. Make sure that the two breathing hoses are on the right side of the right shoulder of your BCD. Place the first stage over the valve and then gently screw until it's closed. Now, it's very important, do not do this too tight. So only 3 fingers tight. It's all okay if your first stage moves a little bit before we open up the tank. Then attach the low pressure inflator hose by pulling back the top of your low pressure inflator hose and connecting it to your inflator hose of the BCD. Make sure afterwards you streamline it. Once this all streamlined looks in order, grab your alternate air source and attach your alternate air source at the right spot of your BCD. Make sure the yellow is shining outwards. Now, if everything looks good, before we open up the tank, turn your SPG away from you so the glass, in the unlikely event, if it damages, it cannot hurt anybody. Hold down the inflator bottom of the BCD and then slowly open up the tank, instantly releasing the inflator button of the BCD. All the way open up the tank until the end. Now, do a full check of your dive equipment by fully inflating the BCD first until air escapes from the BCD, and then wait a second. Make sure there's no leaks. Squeeze it a little bit. So now we check that air actually goes in and that there's no leaks. Then deflate the BCD by releasing all the air. Then check if it also works orally. By putting a bit of air in there, a couple of breaths is enough. Make sure you press down the deflator button when you breathe in. Once that's all okay, then deflate the BCD again. Then grab your second stage in your right hand and your SPG in your left hand. Clean your second stage by perching a little bit, then smelling it, making sure that the air is not contaminated. And then put your second stage in your mouth and breathe in slowly and deeply a few times while looking at your air gauge. Your air gauge needle should stay still. If it moves, then there is a problem. If it is all okay, then put your second stage down again, take out your alternate air source, and repeat the process. Gently breathe in and out, making sure that everything is okay. Replace the alternate air source and make sure that everything is streamlined again. Then, after it's all good and streamlined, gently place your equipment on its side, make a nice little package out of it. As compact as possible. Now, when it all looks good and done, you can walk away. First thing you do is your body picks up the equipment. Be very careful about your back. Hold it with one hand at the tank valve and then the other hand under the tank. Put the tank on your knee. Then the other person first put your right arm in it, then your left arm. Bend forward a little bit, close the Velcro, close the buckle on the belly, and pull down the shoulder straps. Remember to close the chest strap as well. Once you're okay, tell your body that you're okay and he can gently let go. Be even more careful with your back right now because you have a tank on your back. Pull up your body's tank. And then the same way as you got into the tank, your body can now go into the tank as well. Again, make sure that everything looks good and it's streamlined. And now we're ready to start the body check. So remember the body check, BWRAF. The first thing you do, the B is from BCD. So inflate each other's BCDs and check if nothing is leaking. Then deflate each other's BCDs. Once both BCDs are deflated, then orally inflate each other's BCDs, making sure that it all works. 3 breaths should be enough. Then deflate each other's BCDs. And then we have the W from weight belt. Check your body's weight belt. Make sure it's a right hand release, that all the weights are evenly distributed and nothing is twisted or entangled. And vice versa, your body will after that do that with you. If you have integrated weights, then check if the integrated weights are there. Then the R from releases. So check if all the releases are connected and everything is snug. Make sure it's comfortable, not too tight, but of course definitely not too loose. Especially your tank strap is really important that that is connected the right way. Then your body does it on your equipment. Then we go to the A from air. Now, before you take your second stage, first check on your body if the tank is completely open. Make sure you look on the valve and check the arrows. And you open it the right way. Once you checked on each other that the tank is properly opened, then grab your air gauge, hold it in your right hand, and then with your left hand, take the second stage off your body. First, we want to clean it by perching it, then gently perch it to smell the air, and then breathe from it. Take 3 slow deep breaths in and out, and check each other's air gauge, making sure that the needle doesn't move. that is all okay, then you check your body's alternate air source using the same procedure. Make sure that when you put it back, that you streamlined everything correctly, and make sure the yellow is really facing out. Then your body does it on you. And again, always double check if your body does the body check correctly. Once it's all streamlined, you want to do the F for the final OK. Now, the F means that we want to double check everything. So make sure that all the hoses are connected correctly, nothing is entangled, all the air source is under the arm, everything is streamlined and correct any problems that you occur. Make sure that we have a mask, snorkel, streamline the SPG. Make sure we have our fins. Now, then a final OK, and we're ready to go scuba diving. For the giant stride, stand with your toes on the side of the pool, with your fins sticking over. Make sure that everything is clear below you. Put a little bit of air into your BCD, 50%. Once that's okay, left hand on the buckle of your weight belt, right hand palm of the hand, second stage, two fingers on your mask. When you're ready, look forward and then big step forward until you go into the water. Once you reach the surface, keep your mask on and your second stage in your mouth. First, fully inflate your BCD by pressing the inflator button until you hear the sound. And then whenever you're ready, switch to your snorkel and give a big okay to the people still standing on the side. For the buoyancy check on the surface, communicate to your body that you're about to perform the buoyancy check. Put your second stage into your mouth. Then deflate your BCD while holding a normal breath. You should sink down, but be neutrally buoyant at around eye level. If that's the case, then you're properly weighted for the dive. Then, after you perform the scale, fully inflate your BCD again. Make sure there's some water in your snorkel. Then put it in your mouth and forcefully exhaling to clear your snorkel. Start with your mask on and your snorkel in. Put your face in the water. Take a nice couple of breaths. Once you're ready, take a deep breath and switch from your snorkel to your second stage. Make sure you blow bubbles in between switching. Clear your second stage regulator either way you like it, by using the blast method or purging it gently. Take a couple of nice deep breaths. Once you're ready, take a big breath and switch back to your snorkel. Blow bubbles in between and clear your snorkel by using the blast method. Make sure you're next to your body. Mask on, snorkel in, and go face down into the water. Slowly start swimming forward. You can use any fin kick by using the scissor kick or maybe even a frog kick. The distance between you and your body should be around one arm's length away. Keep snorkeling together, and once in a while look at each other to check each other up and communicate by giving the OK signal once in a while, until you're done. First thing that we do is we signal OK to go down. Then the second step is we're going to orientate ourselves by looking around us. And don't forget to look down to make sure that the area below you is completely clear. On step 3, we're going to change from our snorkel to our regulator. Make sure you clear the regulator or the second stage from any water that's inside. Once that's okay, on step 4, we're going to check the time. And then on step 5, we equalize, we elevate, and then we press the deflator button to deflate our BCD and slowly exhale to descend. Make sure on your descent that you equalize your ears. Make sure you look around you and below you. Make sure you communicate with your body on the way down and you stay close to your body. Make sure that we do not touch the bottom. So go into the right trim position. Maybe add a little bit of air in your BCD in the end to stay off that bottom. Once you're perfectly neutrally buoyant at the bottom, communicate to your body again. So the first thing that you do is to deflate your BCD fully. Then gently go down and try to lay flat on your belly. Equalize on the way down if you need to. Then stretch your legs and try to spread them as far as you can. Take a couple of nice relaxed breaths. See if you start to rise when you breathe in, and if not, then just put a little bit of air by using your LPI of the BCD. If it doesn't work, just put a little bit more. Don't worry, you got all the time in the world. Just breathe in slowly and you start to rise. While you're going up, start to breathe out and then you go back down again. The trick is when you go down to start breathing in, because there's a little delay for your lungs to get to the right size for you to go up or down. Just breathe out, we're going down, we start to breathe in, and we're going up. Now breathe out, now go down and breathe in, and you're going up again and you start breathing out. This way you're not touching the surface and you're also not touching the bottom. Okay, once you're done, just deflate your BCD and well done. Start by flooding your mask. The easiest way to do it is just to pull down your mask from the top until it's fully flooded. Then with two fingers, put some pressure at the top frame of your mask. Take a deep breath into your mouth and then out through your nose while you're looking up, until all the water is out of the mask. For the mask removal and replacement, with your left hand grab the mask and with your right hand take off the strap and then take off your mask and your snorkel from your face. Make sure that you hold onto it and that you don't drop it. Then make sure the snorkel's on the side, feel the nose pocket so the mask is not upside down. Move the strap away and then take your hairs out of the way. First your mask on your face and then you put the strap all around. Make sure it's not twisted and that the strap is high above your ears. Double check if everything is okay. With two fingers, touch the top frame of your mask, breathe into your mouth and out through your nose while you're looking up, to clear your mask fully. First of all, with your left hand, grab the mask and with your right hand, the strap. Remove the strap and then remove your mask and your snorkel fully off your face. Make sure that you keep your second stage in your mouth and you make sure that you keep holding onto the mask and do not drop it. Stay like this for at least 1 minute, slowly breathing in and out through your regulator second stage. Slowly breathe in and out. Just remember to only breathe into your mouth and only breathe out through your mouth. Keep holding that mask in front of you. To be honest, If you breathe in slowly and deeply and you breathe out slowly and deeply, it's actually a really relaxing skill. You can keep your eyes open if you want to, but you can also close them if you prefer that. Keep holding onto the mask, breathe in and breathe out. Once the minute is finished, then put the mask back on, first making sure that the nose pocket is down again, snorkel on the side, hair out of the way, put the mask on first, and then the strap. Sure the strap is not twisted again and that it's high above your ears. When everything is in order, with two fingers, touch the top frame of your mask and then breathe into your mouth and out through your nose while looking up, until all the water is cleared from your mask. Start by grabbing your air cage, have it in front of you, so it's easy to look at. Communicate to your dive instructor that you're ready, and then your dive instructor will start turning off your air. This will take a little bit of time. Don't worry. Once the air is completely turned off, then slowly breathe in, and you will see that the needle will go down off your air cage. Very slowly keep breathing in, until the needle hits zero, which means that you're completely out of air. Once that happens, give the clear out of air signal to your instructor, and the instructor will now open up your tank again and you can comfortably breathe again. Whenever you're ready, make contact with your body. Grab your air gauge, tap on your air gauge to ask the air of your body. Your body will give the amount of air. Make sure you're okay to it, that you understand that person. And now the body will ask you. Give him your amount of air and make sure that your body gives you an okay so you understand. Then continue the dive. So the first thing for the 5-point ascent is to signal to your body that you're okay to go up. Then the next step is to check the ending dive time. Then for step 3, go into the right ascent position by moving your right hand above your head to protect your head and your left hand on the deflator button. Step 4, check if everything is clear above you. And on step 5, we're slowly going to swim up to the surface, rotating your body, making sure that everything is clear above you, and keep an eye on your body so you stay close. Do not swim faster than 18 meters per minute. Once we reach the surface, then keep your mask on your face. Keep your regulator second stage in, fully inflate until air escapes from your BCD, and then switch from your regulator second stage to your snorkel. And now you've completed the skill. First of all, grab the ladder with two hands. Then, put your feet on the ladder, make sure that everything is clear around you and especially nobody's behind you. Then, slowly pull yourself up, step for step, with all your equipment on, climb out of the pool. Grab your fins. Start by closing off your scuba tank completely. Turn off the air all the way. Once it's turned off, take out your alternate air source. Hold it with your right hand and then your second stage in your left hand. Perch at exactly the same time both second stages until all the air is released from the hoses and the first stage. Gently put it on the floor. Unstreamline your LPI hose and disconnect it by pulling back the top of the LPI and gently disconnect it. Then, gently unscrew your first stage from the tank valve. And then, very important, remember to dry that dust cap from any water, so no water can enter your first stage. We recommend using a dry cloth or towel for this one. Once it's okay, place back the dust cap on the first stage. Double check everything from any leaks, and once that's okay, you can use what we call a spaghetti loop technique to make a nice little loop out of your regulator system and then gently put it on the floor. Then, release your safety strap, take it off the tank valve, then hold on to the BCD with one hand, release the tank strap, and remove the BCD from the tank cylinder. Gently put it on the floor again and make a nice little package out of it. Then grab the tank and very gently put it on its side on the floor so it can't fall over anymore. Put your BCD and the regulator together. Double check if everything is streamlined. And then you can walk away.